This video, getting a lot of play on the internet, has angered many in the deaf community. The video shows a man who appears to be deaf being put in a chokehold by store security guard who suspects the man of shoplifting. News 4's Tim Waller is covering the story. And Tim, what are people saying about this video?
Well, we showed the video to a clinical counselor in Malden, Carroll, who also happens to be deaf. And without making judgment as to whether the man in the video is guilty of shoplifting, you know, he's been charged, but he hasn't been convicted yet. She was very disturbed by what she saw.
The video shot by a mall customer begins outside the store with a suspect restrained. The security guard has him in a chokehold, while his friend, who is also deaf, tries to show the guard their store receipt and uses sign language to no avail.
It was shocking. I'm shocked.
Megan Covert, a counselor with the Department of Mental Health's Deaf Services, says what should have happened outside that California store didn't.
Really, the guards should have backed away a little bit, let the deaf person express and tell them that they were deaf, instead of the guards just immediately coming in basically attacking them. There was no communication between the two.
Covert says while this is an extreme example of failure to communicate with a deaf person, there are other more subtle instances that occur every day that don't make the news.
Like I bring some clients to the doctor's office and the doctor doesn't provide an interpreter, and we have to continually remind them that they have to provide an interpreter. It's not my position to talk for the clients and to speak for those clients.
She says what happened here illustrates the need for more training and awareness by those in positions of authority.
Just be more open-minded to, if a person doesn't understand, to continue trying to talk, to get paper, to write stuff down, to be able to communicate in some way.
Now, Roger Williams, the statewide director for Deaf Services, told me today he does not expect people in positions of authority all to learn sign language, but he says they do need to take pause in situations like this, like in that video you just saw, to better understand what may be going on. Tim Waller, WYFF News 4, live in the Greenville newsroom.